metal. It's impossible for a diode laser to cut it, right? So there it is. That's a lot of parts. This is like such a fantastic thing. They sent an air assist, and then finally they sent a, what's it? It's called a cutting mat, and you put it up under your stuff so you don't cut the wood table that you're working on. Look at the size of this laser. It's giant. So I'm going to put this together. I will time it, and I will come back and let you know how long it took, whether I had any trouble. All right, now I'm ready to start. I'd left these feet inside the box, so make sure you check the box very well. It's very well packed. Let's go ahead and get this done. Here it is. And it took exactly 28 minutes and 53, almost 54 seconds. So not too bad. I didn't have any problems at all, so came together really good. So let me show you a couple of these features real quick that are on this, and then we're gonna get to cutting and testing and see what this thing can do. It has a 20 watt laser. It has a full color display module that is attached to the chassis by magnetics. It has an emergency stop button in case something goes wrong. Its SD card is positioned on the top of the module here for easy access. The air assist comes with this power cord that splits and can be connected to the air assist and to the laser. It came with this metal mat that goes up under everything so it doesn't cut into your table. The air assist is built into the laser module. The laser module's up and down motion is controlled by this knob. You just loosen the knob up and it can go up or down for focusing. Well, it's time to see what this thing can do, and we're going to try to cut through a few different things, but first, I'm going to focus the laser. Just undo it, drop it down to this with this little focuser that came with it, and it should be focused. So let's go ahead and try to cut these two pieces of metal, the 0.02 and the 0.05. Did that thing just cut through 0.02 millimeter metal and 0.05 millimeter metal? Well, gosh darn it, that's just nifty. That's a powerful laser. There ain't nothing else to test. I'm just going back in. Now you got diode lasers cutting metal now. What the heck? So cutting's great, and I appreciate that it can cut through so much stuff, including metal. Who'd have thought, right? But I want to see how well it will cut, say, an ornament. So let's get that done. Show you how easy it is to use the SD card. We're going to cut out a 1-inch circle on this 3mm plywood. It was that easy to transfer this from the SD card over to the laser. So now what we're going to do is we're going to see how well this engraves and see how they look. We're going to do it on metal and on wood, so let's check that out. All right, with all the smoke around me, you gotta understand, I'm ready to tell you what I think about this machine. First of all, I'm gonna go over the things that I disliked about it, because I always like ending on a positive note. And then I'll tell you what I think about it overall. First of all, it's extremely loud. I don't like how loud it is, the fan. When I'm setting up something to cut, I like to be able to see where the nozzle's at. And with this, it has a mirrored window that you can only see the laser beam through. And I don't like that I can't set it up. I wish it had like a mark, an X, where the corner of the cut or burn will start. So they sent me the honeycomb cutting bed for this machine. It's a little small. It's only 330 millimeters by 210 millimeters. I wish it was at least 350 by 350. So that's it. Those are the things I didn't like about the machine. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy your Moon Pie Creations presentation on everything that is glorious about this machine. If you can't tell, I'm pretty pleased with this machine. First of all, the one thing I think is great about this machine is it cuts metal. How often am I going to cut metal? I don't know. But you tell me if that's a pretty cool little thing that it can cut these out. You can do like little tin stars for ornaments or I don't know, anything. It's kind of neat. Two things came with this machine standard, and that's the air assist and the cutting mat. I think that's brilliant of them to put them with it. So this right here is the display screen. You saw me using it during the video. This is great. It's magnetized on the back and it connects to the front of the machine on the chassis. I really wish that they would make this wireless, as in make that a charging point and have this connect to the machine wirelessly. That would be amazing. But it's still pretty cool to have this. You can bring it up and you can see it and do your stuff and then put it back down. Engraving on metal is pretty cool. You saw how I engraved on stainless steel, high-speed steel, and then even on copper, and they all came out great. I think it's really neat how crisp and clean that right there is. That engraving on this piece of stainless steel is great. It installed pretty easily with Lightburn. All I had to do is manually take the gerbil and then add a name to it, add the size of 400 millimeters by 400 millimeters, and boom, it installed perfectly. So I ran this ornament that you saw me cut on here, in here, and I wanted to compare it to another 20 watt laser that I did the other day. And they both cut really well. I'm pretty sure you know how I feel about this machine, but I'll say it out loud. I really like it. I'm gonna give it about a 9 out of 10. And the only reason I'm giving it 9 is because of the loudness of the fan and the inability to see where you're gonna be cutting at. Now, I understand the price point for this machine isn't in the hobby range, but if you're starting up a business and you're looking for something a little bit cheaper than the other ones, this is the one to get. So that's it. I would recommend this to anybody. I appreciate you stopping by. If you could, hit that thumbs up button and share the video. And if you think I deserved it, hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, head on down to my comment section. Tell me what you think about this machine. I also want to let you know that I'm starting to move all my reviews over to my second channel that you can find down in the description. But I want to tell you I appreciate you coming by. And until next video, stay cool.